Match game 74, production number 0259, take a one. Get ready to match the stars. McLean Stevenson. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Joni Summers. Richard Dawson. And Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Thank you very much, Johnny. Thank you, friends. Now, you don't belong over there. You belong up there.
I want to tell you something, Gene.
What?
I've had it with Brett. Also, these people down here make a lot more money than we're getting. But I did want to take just a moment to thank the people that sent in the card and the letter for the Brett Summers Hearing Aid Fund. We got close to 97 cents, sports fan. We have enough now to get an invisible cord and a cheap battery. But I'm going to ask you not to send any more money in. We found the trouble. Actually, Brett had a huge banana in her ear.
You got to go over there because that's the way you play the game there.
Huh? That hurt.
Do you want to know how blind I am?
Are you rebutting?
I thought he was a real contestant.
No, let's say hello to our real contestant, Carol Ware. Hello, Carol.
Hello.
Carol has won one game, and as time ran out on us last time we were together, she was about to have a go at the big money and the big money super match here. And, what are you hollering, flying, lighting, and all that? Don't talk so loud backstage there, we can hear you. We'll straighten it out during this commercial message, and then we'll get right back to Carol Ware. The Big Money Superman. Here we go with Carol Ware at the Big Money, over $5,000. Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
All right, we polled a recent studio audience, Carol, and we got their best response to this. Blank Rod. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it, the next $250, and the third $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
Hot Rod.
Hot Rod is what you say. They're applauding the Hot Rod.
Charles.
Charles.
Coitin Rod.
Coitin Rod?
Coitin Rod.
Yeah.
C-O-I-T-O-N.
Right. Coitin. Coitin. Curtin Rod.
And Ann.
Ann, what do you say?
I say the old fishing rod.
Yeah. Old fishing rod. Okay. Got some good ones there. Curtin Rod, Hot Rod, and Fishing Rod. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I'll go with Richard and say Hot Rod.
You say Hot Rod. All right. Apparently the audience approves of your decision and of his answer. And we'll find out if it's up there and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response. Lightning Rod is a very good answer, isn't it? All right. Looking for Hot Rod. Here's the $250 response. Fishing Rod is the one Ann gave you.
Our Emmy winner.
Yes, that may be a good omen. Let's find out now where it is, if it is up there. The $500 response. Hot Rod! Oh, boy. Congratulations. As you can see, she's very happy to win $500 because that means she's going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Now, remember to collect. You've got to match one celebrity head-to-head. Which one will it be?
Richard.
All right, Richard. You face me, if you would, please, Carol. And this has to be an exact match. Blank Feed. F-E-E-D. Blank Feed. Now, he's finished. Carol, we ask you to give us an answer which you think will match his. Blank Feed.
Chicken Feed.
Chicken Feed. You know, I was trying to think of an answer and I couldn't think of Chicken Feed, and I said to myself, I'm glad I'm not playing. All right, Richard, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
I would have loved nothing better than to have done what you came up with it so easily. Took me about 20 seconds.
You got a total of $5,600. I know you're very happy about that. We'll meet your new player right after this message. Okay, our current champion has pulled herself together, and we're ready to start another game. To do that, we're very happy to present a new player. Here is D. Rally. Is it Rally or Rayleigh?
Rayleigh.
Rayleigh.
That's okay.
D. Rally. How are you? Nice to have you with us.
Thank you. I'd love to be here.
We'll now hear the D. Rally story.
Not much exciting news to tell. We're from a beautiful little town called Greenbelt, Maryland. We've resided here in Anaheim for 5 years. We're moving back to Greenbelt in about a week and a half, and we're like the Brady Bunch. We have 7 children.
Really?
Uh-huh. Oh, 7 no. Beautiful children.
That's terrific.
Thank you.
Isn't it?
Thank
you. You're moving back to Greenbelt, Maryland. You're not too thrilled with Anaheim or your husband's work change or what?
Well, I love it here, but all our family and relatives are back there, and we're kind of lonesome, and I'm pretty homesick.
Oh,
so
well,
I'm excited.
Money is...
Boy, I can't tell you how I wouldn't go home to my family and relatives.
I wish you would go home to your family and relatives.
Dee, if you're ready, we'll begin here by asking you to make a selection.
Okay, my little girl told me to go with A.
A.
Uh-huh.
And you got to do what your little girl says.
Oh, I wish you were here to answer it.
No, how old is your little girl?
9. That's
nine?
The baby.
I don't know if she'd understand this. Here's what it says here, Dee.
When a 9-year-old Ellen... wouldn't understand it, I know I'm lost.
When Ellen went streaking through Murray's Delicatessen, she came out with blank. All over her. Ellen. When Ellen went streaking through Murray's Delicatessen, she came out with blank all over her.
I get it. There are just a lot of choices.
Yes, there are a number of good choices.
Oh!
Murray's Delicatessen. All right, I guess we're all set.
I'm going to take a course in spelling. There's just no question about it.
Spelling really doesn't mean anything here.
I know. I told you it's self-pride.
All right. Now, Dee. When Ellen went streaking through Murray's Delicatessen, she came out with blank all over her.
I'm going to try salami.
Salami.
Does it sound all right?
Yeah. Well, I guess there are a number of good choices there. What are you doing there, McLean? You're peeling a banana.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was taking a lunch break.
Oh, no.
What did she say?
She said when Ellen went streaking through Murray's Delicatessen, she came out with salami all over her.
Yeah.
What do you say? We've had our lunch break. But...
I said, wah, 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 wah. Cream cheese.
Cream cheese. There's another loser. Okay, Brett.
I'm not speaking to McLean.
All right.
Because I
promise?
Said... I said sauerkraut.
Sauerkraut? Okay.
She said, wonderful person up there with taste and perception
said
about
yay.
People yayed.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, whoever. The yayed. Charles, salami.
You thought your son was home in bed. Chicken liver.
Chicken liver is a good answer. And Murray's Delicatessen chicken liver would be a splendid answer. Joni, what did you say?
And then there is also hot pastrami.
Hot pastrami is another good one. Getting close to salami.
We certainly are. We'll be there in about 3 hours. I suggest we all have a nap. I happen to know she's a slippery little devil.
Oh, she is.
Came out covered in chicken fat.
Oh, chicken fat.
Slipped
on her
option.
Went right through your arms. What do you say?
Well, I mean, if you're streaking and if this girl has a good figure, then it would be like cheesecake, but I went for cream cheese.
Cream cheese.
Yes, I did.
All right, salami didn't work for you. Now let's find out what Carol's got and what's going to work for her. Dr. Quacalini told Jack, Hey, you take these two garlic cloves and put them into your nose. Jack did, and in no time at all, his blank went away. Or his blank went away. It's the advice he was getting from Dr. Quacolini.
And I think of the letters.
You take a two garlic clove and put them into your nose. And he did.
In no time.
And in no time at all, his blank went away.
Oh! I think I've got
okay.
it here.
All right.
Now, you see, sometimes I think I'm too smart for this show.
Yeah.
Why is Charlie
always last? Now, Carol. Dr. Quacolini told Jack, you take a two garlic cloves and put them in your nose. And Jack did, and in no time at all, his blank went away.
I'll say his cold.
His cold.
He said, that's the way to get rid of a cold, McLean. What'd you say?
Sure, but he's not a real doctor, I'll bet.
I guess he isn't. No, not with a name like Quacolini.
I said, face.
Face. Who is that masked man walking through the room? Brett. Yeah. All right, Brett, what do you say?
Do you know I started to say face?
Yeah.
But I changed my mind because I thought McLean might say it. And I don't want to be identified with him in any way, shape, or form. What actually happened to him was that his breath went away.
His breath went away. He's flailing your answer with a dead banana. All right, Charles.
Over the years, they've lost the idea of this game. The lovely girl puts up a word, and then the celebrity turns around and matches it.
Yes, that's the idea.
Very simple.
Just to refresh your memory, Dr. Quacolina told Jack, take a two garlic cloves and put them in your nose, and he did, and in no time at all, his blank went away. What'd you
Some time ago, I heard someplace, and I really don't remember where, that you take garlic for a cold.
A cold.
I heard that in my whole life.
Okay, yeah, that's true. I've heard that. What'd you say, Richard?
Garlic is to keep vampires away, darling.
Vampires?
Yeah, the other thing is to unblock your sinuses.
That's right.
This happens to be a medical recipe, folks, not a joke. People walking all over town with garlic up their nose.
And what
How
do you
are
say?
You? I'm fine,
thank you. Sneeze at, my dear.
It certainly
is. It is, and is it? I wouldn't sneeze garlic. I said cold and sniff.
Good girl. Cold and sniff. Okay. And that's three for you, and that's what the score is. 3-0 at the end of round one. Round two coming along in a moment or so, so stick around. Now, here we go with round two coming up. Dee, would you make a selection here?
B, please.
B?
Uh-huh.
All right.
My little girl told me to take A first and B second. Now I'm praying.
Okay. So it's 3-0, favor of our current champ. You didn't match anybody in the first round, so that means everybody plays now. Fat Fanny went to the costume party dressed as Moby Dick, the great white whale. Some fat guy dressed as a sailor tried to blank her. Good?
But what do you mean now, Splendid. Think? If I could think, I wouldn't be doing
it's
this.
It's easy. Now do it.
Now, say it again, honey.
Fat Fanny went to the costume party dressed as Moby Dick, the great white whale, and some fat guy dressed as a sailor tried to blank her.
I get it.
Finally.
Well, you may not be too thrilled, but I get it.
Okay.
I'll be singing all your familiar
Does it make
places?
You write faster? Okay.
I'm writing as fast as I can. I only went to the fourth grade.
All right, Dee. Fat Fanny went to the costume party dressed as Moby Dick, the great white whale. Some fat guy dressed as a sailor tried to blank her.
Fat guy dressed as a sailor.
What's that?
Would you read it one more time?
Sure.
My mind has gone completely blank.
Fat Fanny went to the costume party dressed as Moby Dick, the great white whale. And some fat guy dressed as a sailor tried to blank her.
Okay. Tried to hook her, you know, like you're fishing, hooker.
Hooker.
You know.
Well,
sorry.
I don't know. That's your answer.
Like, you know, like you're fishing.
Okay. Tried to hook her. McLean?
Excuse me?
That's as plain
Some
as I can.
Some fella did what with a hoop?
Okay.
Some fat guy dressed as a sailor tried to
hook.
Sure. I put harpoon.
Now, I have one of the questions. Yeah, but it's a whale.
It's a form of hooking.
Just one little point here. McLean says there is a hook
there
and a harpoon.
A harpoon.
Oh, it's a barb.
No, no. There's a hook.
Really?
In fact,
there's a hook on a knitting needle, you idiot.
Know that.
All right, no, that's the final decision there.
It's called a harpoon hook.
A harpoon hook. Yeah, okay, you lost. That's Brett, what do you say?
Well, actually, they're both wrong. What he tried to do was take her out to sea.
Oh, really? Okay, Charles.
Stop.
Oh, well, don't be so hateful about the buzzer and so quick to jump on it. Go ahead, dear.
Take her out to sea. Stop dreaming. Harpoon.
Harpoon. Now you've got to match the three remaining celebrities with Hook to stay in the game. Joni?
I'm with everybody else but her. I'm sorry, Harpoon.
Harpoon. Harpoon. Yes. Okay. So it's another 100 for you, and it's piling up, and we'll say goodbye to D'Reilly. I'm sorry that it's such a short meeting for you.
That's
okay. We've
got
a gift for you.
Oh, thank you very much.
And good luck on your trip back to Maryland. Goodbye, Dee.
Thank you.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes.
You know how this goes.
Yes.
We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Day of the blank.
Oh, well.
Day of the blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, $250, and $100. You know that. Three celebrities are allowed to help.
I'll take Charles.
Day of the Jackal.
Day of the Jackal.
I'll take Ann.
Day of the Dolphin.
Day of the Dolphin.
Oh, yeah. I know.
And Richard.
Oh.
Day of the Week.
Day of the Week. All right, so you've got Day of the Jackal, Day of the Dolphin, and Day of the Week. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
I'll take Day of the Jackal.
You're letting the audience influence you, aren't you?
No.
No?
No, I'm smart enough on my own.
Okay, good girl. Day of the Jackal is the one she's looking for. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Day of the Week. That's the one that Richard gave you. All right, we're still looking for Day of the Jackal. Here's a $250 response. Day of the Dolphin. All right, so far, two out of three that's up there, the one that Ann gave you. Last chance for Day of the Jackal. Here's the $500 response. There it is! Okay, Carol. You've got the $500. Now you play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Whom do you select there for this?
Charles.
All right, get ready to write, Charles.
I hate this. Okay.
Now, you face me, and it's nerve-wracking time for Charles.
Just think of all the money you got already. Bill slowly.
This has to be an exact match, folks.
Tell me.
Blank alive. Blank alive. A-L-I-V-E. Blank alive. Okay, you ready, Charles?
Well, this ain't easy.
Carol, what answer do you come up with in order to match him in filling in this blank? Blank alive.
Buried alive.
Buried alive is good. All right, Charles, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
If you promise me one thing.
Yes, what?
When I turn my card around, would you please throw a pail of cold water on Carol Ware?
Well, sir. You sure can run fast. Oh, incidentally, congratulations. You know how much money you got now? $11,200. Here comes another player. Let's welcome Donna Sue Solomon. Hello there, Donna Sue.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine.
You want to step up there? Stop rolling, I guess. You gals know each other?
Sure.
You want to tell us about Donna Sue Solomon while I catch my breath here? Where are you from and all that?
Oh, I'm from Los Angeles. I'm a native.
Yep.
And I'm single. And I'm a student at UCLA studying
Wait,
to be...
Wait, do that again. McLean didn't hear that adjective. You're why?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm single.
Okay. All right, Donna Sue. I guess we can't start this game, right? We've got to pause here for a message, and we'll be right back to it. Join us next time. Goodbye. Thank you.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Hudson, Bill Chapman production.